Shout out to this fan for coming up with the idea to this video. If you have any cool ideas for a future video, let me know in the comments below. I may just give you a shout out.
3, 2, 1.
What's up, my Net Soldiers? I am Net Alliance, and they were asked the question, what if Anakin left Obi-Wan behind on the Invisible Hand in Revenge of the Sith? Now, if you enjoy this theory and you'd like to see more, make sure to click the card at the top of the screen, or wait till the end of this video. There will be a link to my theory playlist. Also, if you're a subscriber of mine and you're feeling like being awesome, make sure to join the notification squad, as my subs call it, by clicking the little bell button beneath this video. It'll notify you every time I upload a new video, so you can get my videos first. And also, I'll respond to anyone who comments within the first hour of this video being up. So, there you go. But without further ado, let's begin. Anakin stood tall over the decapitated corpse of the fallen Count Dooku. In one hand, he held his sapphire blue lightsaber. In the other, he held the curved lightsaber hilt of Dooku, its crimson blade pulsing with power, as if it was calling to him. Skywalker disengaged the blades and took a moment to regain himself. Then he heard a voice. You did well, Anakin. He was too dangerous to be kept alive. Anakin released Palpatine from his restraints, as they talked of the morality of Skywalker's decision, for Anakin was conflicted on the situation. Dooku had been an enemy for so long, and had killed many of his friends. Palpatine was right, Dooku was too dangerous to be left alive. However, as good as it was to take Dooku's life, Anakin knew it wasn't right to kill an unarmed man, and had Obi-Wan been conscious at the time, he probably would have held Skywalker at bay. But Kenobi didn't stop him, and honestly, it did feel pretty good. Now, from this point in the film, Anakin would save Obi-Wan and escape along with the Chancellor. But what if Anakin left Obi-Wan behind? What would happen? Let's explore. So I realized that at this point in the film, Anakin would have never left Obi-Wan behind. In fact, the only way Anakin would have, in my opinion, was if Obi-Wan was dead. And even still, I could see Anakin kind of dragging Kenobi's dead body with him. But just for the sake of story, let's say while Dooku and Anakin were dueling, Sidious used the Force to choke Kenobi's body until he died. So once Skywalker went to check on his old master, he felt no pulse, signifying Kenobi's death. Now this angered Anakin, and gave him further clarity on his decision to kill Dooku. He no longer felt regret for his actions. In fact, he felt great. Skywalker got his vengeance, and although it wouldn't bring Kenobi back, he could at least find comfort in the fact that Dooku was gone for good. Skywalker contemplated bringing Obi-Wan's body, but it would only slow the rescue down, and every second Anakin and Palpatine wasted on the Invisible Hand put their lives further in danger. So the men left the room, heading for an escape. Now, from this point, there are many different things that could happen, but I'm inclined to use the situation from the Revenge of the Sith book. Now, we don't actually see this scene in the movie, but it is an interesting scene in the book. Essentially, while Kenobi is passed out, Palpatine urges Skywalker to face Grievous. He's pretty much like, Anakin, look, leave Obi-Wan's lifeless body next to me. I'll watch over him. You go take down Grievous quick. You're strong enough. You can do it, bud. Come on, you can do it. And although that's not exactly what Palpatine says, that's what he pretty much does say. Now in the book, Anakin is tempted, but ultimately decides not to, due to Kenobi being knocked out, and their mission ultimately being to rescue the Senator, not kill Grievous. But this time, there was no Obi-Wan, and Palpatine seemed to be fine. So with the Chancellor coaching Anakin, I believe Skywalker would go and face Grievous alone. Anakin walked into the ship's control bridge. Grievous noticed the Jedi right away.
Ah, General Skywalker. Congratulations on killing Count Dooku. You have just secured my promotion.
Grievous, you're shorter than I expected. Anakin quipped, igniting his lightsaber.
The general laughed while holding Obi-Wan's lightsaber in his hand. One of his droids must have retrieved it for him.
I'm glad we finally get to face off. It's a shame Kenobi won't be able to join us.
Skywalker's snarky demeanor quickly transformed to pure anger, and he charged Grievous, dicing down two battle droids in one swing. General Grievous wielded two blades as he moved to the defense, slicing down whatever got in his way. Anakin's Sejemso was incredible, possibly the strongest use of the form Grievous had ever seen. But for the cyborg, he was taking his time, analyzing Skywalker's movements, waiting for the right time to strike. Now, after a brief battle, Anakin would eventually win the fight, due to Palpatine's intervention using the Force to slow Grievous down. And with Dooku and Grievous dead, the Separatists would be all but defeated, allowing Palpatine to execute Order 66 sooner. Also, with Obi-Wan dead and gone, I believe Anakin's turn would be even easier for Palpatine, meaning Skywalker may convert to Vader even sooner. And like I previously mentioned, with the Separatist leaders taken out, I believe the Republic would push to have all their Jedi out in the field really taking down the rest of the Separatist forces, which of course would be the perfect move on Palpatine's part, and he would execute Order 66 before his emergency powers were taken from him. But there would be a lot of other stuff impacted by this as well. First off, how is Padme gonna deal with Anakin becoming Darth Vader? I personally think she would take her kids and leave. Maybe go to a distant planet far, far away so Anakin couldn't find them. But of course, this is all just my opinion. What is your opinion on this? How do you think Anakin leaving Obi-Wan behind really would affect this entire story? Let me know in the comments below. Please remember to like and subscribe for more videos. And until next time, guys, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace.